Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernard from the BTN HD, and today is all about installing data dedupe on Windows Server 2019. So let's get started. So first thing that you need to do is open up your server manager. The current operating system version that I'm running is Windows Server 2019 Data Center. And from here, what you want to do is click on Manage, Add Roles and Features. You're going to get the nice Add Roles and Features wizard. Click on Next, Next again, Next again. And once you get to the server row, you want to expand File and Storage Services. And then you want to expand File and iSCSI Services. And the one that you want is Data Dedupe. So check it. Is that easy. Click on Next. Next again. I like to click on Restart the Destination Server Automatically if Required. I click on Yes. Click on Install. And it takes between, I would say, 2 to 5 minutes. I think it's less than that. And once it's completed, you're going to get the installation succeeded. Close it, and you're done. Somewhat done. From here, you're going to click on File and Storage Services, and click on Volumes, and you're going to pick your volume that you want to enable data dedupe. You're going to right-click on your volume and pick Configure Data Deduplication. You're going to get a nice little setting right here. By default, again, it is disabled. You could click on the drop-down menu, and it gives you a couple of options. I'm going to pick File Server because this volume is going to be all about saving particular files in there. You have options to do virtual desktops as well as virtualized backup servers, okay? So pick the option that fits in your environment. For me, I'm going to do general purpose for File Server. You are able to set a schedule right here. If not, you are able to just click Apply, OK it. If you didn't schedule your data dedupe, you are able to start it manually. So you right-click on the Start menu, click on Windows PowerShell as an admin level. And from here, you're going to do the following commandlet. Start dedupe job with a parameter of type optimization, another parameter of volume. Pick a volume. Mine was E drive. And the priority is going to be high. Now, this option here is not recommended during working hours. This is after working hours. Enter, and there it goes. It's in queue, and that's it. That is how we start the dedupe job on a particular volume. Now, my volume was the E drive. You are able to check the status of Git dedupe status, and then hit enter. And it's going to give you a nice little summary of what has been saved within the particular volume. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoy how to install data dedupe within your Windows Server 2019. Don't forget about hitting that like button. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.